making noise in the streets. Haymakers like a fire, throwing hooks to a beat. I got my finger on my pulse, it's steady. I was built for the speed. Automatic shift gears, I'm ready. Headstrong, I believe. When I close my eyes and count to ten, all I feel is the adrenaline. And when the pain begins to set, all I hear is, long live the champion. Long live the champion. Call me names, call me reckless. Crash through like a storm. Filled with fury, I'm relentless. Like a soldier at war.
At American Safeguard Insurance, you get an actual human being just down the street to get advice on the confusing world of insurance. There's no need to shop around every time your insurance company tries to raise rates. You can relax and let us do it for you. Having a choice is a big deal, and when insurance companies compete, you save money. One of the most important benefits is we actually monitor your premium for rate increases. If we notice a rate increase, we reshop your premium to ensure the best rate. And when the time comes to use your insurance, and we hope it doesn't, you have a friend to help guide you during one of the most stressful times of your life. All your needs under one roof, from vehicle to life insurance, and everything in between. We protect it all.
Hey folks, Sean Gorham here for Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs, the Lake Area's fastest growing GM dealership, where we make your car buying experience easy and enjoyable. Simply shop cowboyscbg.com, where you can pick out your vehicle, get an appraisal, pre-approval, and even purchase from your living room. Every new vehicle purchased comes with a complimentary 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and we deliver anywhere in the state. The service don't stop there. We also have a state-of-the-art service facility and collision repair center. So for all your automotive needs, come see us at Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs.
Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy has been serving the Greers Ferry Lake area since 1976. They are located on the back side of the Court Square in downtown Heber Springs. Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy offers private consultations, Medicare enrollment, and immunizations for pneumonia, flu, COVID, shingles, tetanus, and more. They also test and treat strep and flu. Their staff is committed to providing fast and friendly service. Stop by today to see why Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy is Greer's Ferry Lake's number one independent pharmacy. FL Davis is more than just a hardware store. With 6 locations to serve you in Heber Springs, Greers Ferry, Sherwood, Pea Ridge, Fayetteville, and Centerton, they are your one-stop shop for hardware and home improvement. They are also the home of the Lake Boutique, featuring clothing, footwear, jewelry, accessories, baby items, home decor, and kitchen items. Whether you're building a new home, improving your old one, or needing a gift for yourself or someone else, stop by one of their locations and experience all that they have to offer.
Nobody has sold more Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram vehicles than the Landers family. If you're looking for a hassle-free, stress-free buying experience, then Cowboy Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram in Clinton is your place to shop. We've got all the trucks you're looking for with brand new V8 Ram trucks starting at just $29,988. If there's a job to be done, we've got the truck for it. Ram 2500, 3500, gas or diesel, crew cab, mega cab, or cab and chassis. We've got all the trucks. Nobody will beat a Cowboy deal on your next Jeep with up to $5,000 off or an available 0% interest. Shop us today. Jeep Gladiator, Wrangler, Grand Cherokee, Wagoneer. It's all in stock and ready to deliver. If you want to pay too much, buy somewhere else. If you want the car deal you've always waited for, Cowboy Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Clinton is your place to shop. It's quick and easy. Jump online at cowboycdjr.com or give us a call at 501-745-5333. Cowboy up or you'll pay too much.
Ivy Physical Therapy in Heber Springs is a proud supporter of the Lake Area Athletes. If you or your student athlete are looking to get back in shape or for therapy after an injury, give Ivy Physical Therapy a call at 501-362-8118 or visit ivyphysicaltherapy.com.
Trust, they specialize in installation and creation of custom wood trusses for your home or business. Knapp Truss utilizes only premier lumber to ensure our products last. When you come to Knapp Truss, you will have the peace of mind knowing you're receiving the best quality construction for the best price in the area. Knapp Truss staff members have years in the industry and know what it takes to install a quality truss from the start finish. Call Knapp Truss at 870-948-2105 today.
What do you do with your Ram truck? Are you pulling a trailer? Pulling a boat to the lake to enjoy some time with your family? Or are you enjoying nature and taking your Ram off-road? Whatever you're doing with your Ram, Red River Dodge of Heber Springs has the Ram for you.
And you know what they say, you can't believe everything you see on the internet. And that's true right now. Not every new Ram truck that we have is showing up online. Go to our website at redriverdodge.com and let us get what you want right to your front doorstep. Or make that beautiful drive to Heber Springs during Ram Power Days.
And good afternoon and welcome to the AAA Digital Network Compliments of Lake Area Sports. I'm Richard Sharp, broadcasting to you live from Harding Academy, the site of the Class 3A State Volleyball Tournament. We have reached day two of our coverage, quarterfinal Wednesday, as Atkins is set to take on Hoxie in our opener here of our coverage right here at 12 o'clock noon. Atkins is the number one seed out of the 3A Northwest. Hoxie, the number two seed out of the 3A Northeast. Their starting lineups for Atkins. They're coached by Tracy Brown, assistant coach Randy Mizar. Number one, Caitlin Isley, the senior. Number five, Emerson Gately, the senior. Number seven, Tommy Peters, a senior. The libero, number eight, Paige Ferguson, a senior. Number 10, Lexi Gooden, a senior. Number 23, Corey Keister, a senior. And number 35, Abby Grace Cunningham, a junior. For Hoxie, they're coached by Brandy Johns and Bailey Haskins. The libero, number one, senior, Bella Bradley. Number 10, Kara Forrester, a senior. Number 15, Olivia Compton, a sophomore. Number 21, Bailey Prater, a junior. Number 23, Ellery Gillham, a senior. Number 33, Chloe Prater, a senior. And number 34, Nadia Greer, a sophomore. As we're about ready to get underway here, our first quarterfinal matchup of the day here between the home team on the scoreboard, the Atkins Lady Red Devils, and the visitors on the scoreboard, the Hoxie Lady Mustangs. Appreciate everybody for tuning in here on Lake Area Sports. Looks like Atkins will serve first. With the serve, it'll be number 35, Abby Grace Cunningham, and we're underway. Here's your shot over the net for Gillham with Hoxie, and there's our first point. It's going to come courtesy of Emerson Gatley, the senior, comes through with a shot just barely over the net that grazed over the net, but it gets down for the point. Atkins strikes first. Both these teams took the floor in Rosebud yesterday in first round action as a double hit will be charged to Hoxie, giving the Lady Red Devils their second point. Both these teams in first round action yesterday at Rambler Arena, not too far from here in White County at Rosebud. And there's a big kill for number one, Caitlin Isley. Quick 3-0 advantage here for Atkins. Oh, and a good block there by Isley. She comes through with the block, but it goes out of bounds. And on the board go the Lady Mustangs. Another block, but another point for Atkins. And another double hit. Two double hits. Hoxie has been penalized for now. And that one just barely gets over the net. The serve there from number three, Mia Leah Brewer. If I mispronounced her name, I apologize. Mia Leah. The senior comes through with another serve. As the block attempt goes out of bounds, Hoxie tacks on their second point. There's the serve from Bailey Prater. And it hits the net, falls short of the intended destination. Now Atkins will serve once more. That was a serve from Gately, Emerson Gately, the senior. Point to Hoxie. Atkins is starting. Five seniors and a junior in their libero. Paige Ferguson is a senior as well for Hoxie. Two seniors. Three seniors, four seniors, a sophomore, one sophomore, and a junior. Four seniors, two sophomores, and one junior for Hoxie. As just like that, another quick 2 points added on for Atkins. Make it 3 points now, and they are in double digits on the scoreboard. And we're going to have a timeout taken by Hoxie, first of the match. And we'll take the timeout with them and be back here from Searcy, bring you the rest of this first set on Lake Erie Sports. Back out of the timeout taken by Hoxie. They trail it 10-3 here to Atkins. A battle of a number one seed and a number two seed. Atkins the top seed out of the Northwest. Hoxie the second seed out of the Northeast. And that one's going to go for a point for Hoxie. Prater with the hit, the junior, as Gilham, the senior, will serve for the Lady Mustangs. Prater gets the serve across. Excuse me, it's Gilham. Atkins with yet another point. Corey Keister's going to check back in for the Lady Red Devils. She'll replace Brewer. Soft hit over the net. Nice dig for Atkins. That was Peters, Tommy Peters. Libero Brady gets it for Hoxie. And that shot from Greer is going to sail out of bounds as the lead swells to 9 for Atkins, 13-4 here in the opening set. And they'll score off the serve as is deflected off Brady. And out of bounds once again. Double-digit lead now for the Lady Red Devils. If you're wondering how we got here, Atkins shut out Boonville yesterday over at Rosebud, 3-0 for Hoxie. They're victorious over Mayflower, 3-0. So Lady Red Devils continue their onslaught here. Serving it up there was, I believe, number 7, Peters. It's our first matchup of this quarterfinal Wednesday. Coming up at 2 o'clock, Hackett will take on Episcopal. At 4 o'clock, Baptist Prep will duel with Paris. And the nightcap at 6 o'clock, Crowley's Ridge Academy will battle Harding Academy, the host here. Speaking of the host, they were able to survive in advance with a 3-2 victory last night over Charleston. They were down 2-1 heading into the fourth set, but they forced a fifth and final set and were victorious in it, 15-10, and were able to hang on, survive in advance, they call it, at this time of year, this time of the season. Nothing that Hoxie could do there. Just watch the ball sail to the floor and down for another point. Atkins has been on a tear here in this first set. They lead it by 12. Make it 11 now on the kill from Kara Forrester, the senior. Gets her team back on the board. Oh, wow. I mean, that hit the hand of Greer and it just fell right to the floor. One of those quick bang-bang plays. Not much you can do about that. So much power on that hit from Atkins. But that one fails to go over the net for number 35, Abby Grace Cunningham. The junior will come out. So believe the libero's now in. Paige Ferguson for Atkins as they tack on another point. They are flirting with the 20-point mark, 20-point barrier. Will they get to it on this serve? We'll see on this series. And they will! Nice block there by Osley. 20-7. Lady Red Devils, 5 points away from taking this first set. Prater. Peters setting it up, and it goes down for another point. I believe that was Osley once again. And That one just barely grazes over the net, but it's enough. It's Brewer with another serve. 3 points away now. Atkins is from ending this first set and going up 1-0. Oh, nice block once again. Osley on a tear. My goodness. She is carrying the torch here for Atkins early on in this quarterfinal matchup. As it looks like Episcopal has made it here into the gymnasium in Searcy, Harding Academy. I was able to print off the state, all state selections for this season. I'll get that to you when I can find it. I have it here amongst my notes. So Atkins 2 points away now. Hoxie gets into double digits on the scoreboard. Cutting it to 13. I've fallen way behind on the score. Apologies, ladies and gentlemen. 23-10. Wow, what a save. Nice dig there from Ferguson. And it goes out of bounds just slightly outside of the inbound line there. And it's through. Who else but Isley? Another kill. Serving here will be Gately for Atkins. They could win this first set right here. Another great save there from Ferguson. I believe it went out of bounds over near the Hoxie bench, and they hang around for their 12th point. Serving's the libero for Hoxie, Bella Brady. Return fire from Ferguson. Setting it up for number 23, Gilham. And nearly another kill there for Osley. Hoxie able to back it up. And she does get a kill there. And the first set goes to the Atkins Lady Red Devils. They lead it 1-0 here over the Hoxie Lady Mustangs here in this quarterfinal round of this Class 3A state tournament here at Harding Academy. We'll bring you the second set here on Lake Area Sports. Let's swing it to another great sponsor of ours, and we'll be back here from Searcy in a few moments.
FL Davis is more than just a hardware store. With 6 locations to serve you in Heber Springs, Greers Ferry, Sherwood, Pea Ridge, Fayetteville, and Centerton, they are your one-stop shop for hardware and home improvement. They are also the home of the Lake Boutique, featuring clothing, footwear, jewelry, accessories, baby items, home decor, and kitchen items. Whether you're building a new home, improving your old one, or needing a gift for yourself or someone else, stop by one of their locations and experience all that they have to offer.
Nobody has sold more Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep Ram vehicles than the Landers family. If you're looking for a hassle-free, stress-free buying experience, then Cowboy Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep Ram in Clint is your place to shop. We've got all the trucks you're looking for with brand new V8 Ram trucks starting at just $29,988. If there's a job to be done, we've got the truck for it. Ram 2500, 3500, gas or diesel, crew cab, mega cab.
And welcome back here from Searcy. Set two about to begin here between the Atkins Lady Red Devils and the Hoxie Lady Mustangs. This Atkins student section getting it started there. Lady Red Devils were victorious in the first set, 25-12. How will Hoxie respond? They'll serve first. A serve from Forrester. And Atkins will strike first, picking right back up where they left off in the opening set. Oh, that one misplayed there by Prater. Was on the serve there, and the point, Cunningham. 2-0 here. It's set two. Atkins leads. And a point from Prater as that one deflects off the hand of Cunningham and goes near, or it does go up into the stands closest to the two teams' bench. And Hoxie comes through with their first point. And they're going to give the point off the double hit from Atkins. We are tied now, giving the point to the Lady Mustangs. And Prater, she had a great first set. That one, a little bit too much English on it. Goes out of bounds, and Hoxie leads it now for the first time in set two. All right, Osley. Getting it over, and wow, hard hit from Gooden for Atkins, out of bounds once again. Four straight points, I believe, here for Hoxie. They lead it by two. Oh, what a save there by Ferguson. As I believe they're going to say, number 23, hit the net. That was Corey Keister. Oh, good block there. In on the block was Keister and Isley for Atkins to keep the play alive. And Isley with the kill once again. As I mentioned moments ago, a great first set for her, 6 kills and 3 blocks in that 25-12 victory. Oh, I thought it was a kill. I don't think they've added the point yet. Should be 6-3. Oh no, That's right. It's 5-4. It was 5-2, now 5-3. Apologies for that. I got mixed up there. So the serve from Brewer. And a big kill for Gilham. As the lead was shrunk down to 1. Now it just slightly grows back out to 2. I want to give a shout out to my good friend, the sports editor for the Russellville Courier, the My good friend, Mr. Scott McDonald, he's texting me, watching along there, as Atkins is one of his teams that are in action today. I believe Paris is the other team he's covering as well, so shout out to him. And for Atkins, that set win was their 22nd straight game victory. They've won their previous seven matches via a 3-0 sweep. So thanks to Scott for that info, passing along to the viewers. They're going to give it to Atkins, another point. We're knotted up, 6 apiece. Oh, a quick drop down. Isley, man, each time her number's been called, she's answered the call. And she puts her team back up on top here in the second set, 7-6. Prater. And that one is going to go out of bounds off the last touch by Isley. She's trying to add to her kill total for the day. Serving here, Gilham, and a deflection into or back against the back wall over here to our right. Out of bounds. And another kill, Isley. And it looks like she'll serve. She'll have the next serve for Atkins. Yet another tie here in set two. Good serve by Isley. And it stays in bounds. The kill credited to Gooden. Number 10, Lexi Gooden, the senior. Just keeps it in bounds there and makes it 9-8. And trying to go for the block was Atkins. Instead, it sails out of bounds near the team there on the sideline, near the bench. Back and forth, they continue to go. Oh, way to keep it alive is... It was hit over to Cunningham, but she just catches the ball. She knew it was going to be a fourth hit if she tried to go for it. There was no point in trying to send it back over. Quick 2 points for Hoxie, just like that. They're the first team to get to double digits on the scoreboard. And lead it by two, breaking a 9-9 tie. As they're going to say, 21, I believe, touched the net. That was Prater for Hoxie. Tommy Peters ready for the serve for Atkins. Brady. Now Prater, and it goes out of bounds. Peters trying to make a play on it, and it hits to the right side. Atkins dominated that first set. Of course, they were victorious 25-12, but it has been a much more competitive second set. 12-11 now. Sometimes it takes one set to get adjusted to your opponent and the atmosphere, as these two teams did not get to play here yesterday. They did play at Rosebud. So this is a new gymnasium for them playing in this postseason. As for Baptist Prep, Paris, Crowley's Ridge Academy, and Harding Academy, they all played here yesterday and will take the floor here later on today for the second time in this tournament. And the block is unsuccessful. Has fallen to the floor. There's Cunningham. And the point goes to Hoxie. To 14-11 our score. Nice serve there by Forrester. But the point will go to Atkins. Oh, and a nice block. Isley again. Down for the point. Now we're knotted up. Too much on the hit from Prater. Lady Red Devils watch it sail out of bounds. Changing out the volleyballs there. It went dead silent on that whistle. Nobody was certain of what was going on. Official said, exchange the volleyballs. Oh, shot falls short for Cunningham. And she'll check out. In for her, the libero, Paige Ferguson. That breaks another tie. Solid hit by Brady. That was Isley as Greer was there to recover. And an infraction against Atkins puts Hoxie up two now. Another block. Isley stuffing the stat sheet here in this contest. Wow. Brady serves the libero for the Lady Mustangs. And another kill. Same old song and dance. Caitlin Isley, the senior. She is helping keep her team in this. They only trail by one. Getting it over on the third hits, Prater for Hoxie. Oh, look at that. Poetry in motion. Isley as Gilham trying to go for the block. It ends up in the net. 17 all. And it stays in bounds. Wow. Very close call there. They do just keep it in bounds. As this is what you like to see here in this first matchup of quarterfinal action. Isley, another point. That hit was too much for Gilham to send back. And it's in for a kill. That was number 10, Kara Forrester, for the Lady Mustangs. And down for another kill, Forrester, back to back for her. So here's Hoxie, needing 5 points to tie it up at 1-1 in set victories. And now they need four. Just sneaking it over the net was number 33, Chloe Prater. And we're going to have a timeout taken by Atkins. They trail it by three here in the second set. Don't go anywhere. Keep it locked right here on Lake Area Sports. We'll bring you the rest of this second set from Searcy in a few moments.
At Knapp Truss, they specialize in insulation and creation of custom wood trusses for your home or business. Knapp Truss utilizes only premier lumber to ensure our products last. When you come to Knapp Truss, you will have the peace of mind knowing you're receiving the best quality construction for the best price in the area. Knapp Truss staff members have years in the industry and know what it takes to install a quality truss from the start to finish. Call Knapp Truss at
And we're back out of the timeout. Hoxie leads Atkins 21-18 in the second set of this Class 3A state tournament quarterfinal matchup here from Harding Academy. They've been great hosts here in Searcy. Oh, look at number 10 again, Forrester. Wow. I believe she's had three of the last 4 points or so, maybe the last three here for Hoxie. Oh, but just like that, Atkins strikes right back with a point of their own. Hoxie needs three to win it. Atkins needs three to tie it. And the serve from the Lady Red Devils. Oh, and a nice block. That was Gooden. She's back in the scoring column with that block. And the deficit is now just down to two. Oh, but it sails out of bounds. The serve from Peters. And all the Lady Mustangs watched it go out of bounds. Prater serving, and her serve is too much. Too much mustard on her serve. 23-21. Down to the wire they come in the second set. Nice hit by Prater. Gilham gets it across. Getting across was Peters there for Atkins. And it's going to go to Atkins, the point. They now trail by one. And another timeout taken. This one taken by Hoxie as they lead now by only one. Let's take it with them. Be right back here on Lake Area Sports.
What do you do with your Ram truck? Are you pulling a trailer? Pulling a boat to the lake to enjoy some time with your family? Or are you enjoying nature and taking your Ram off-road? Whatever you're doing with your Ram, Red River Dodge of Heber Springs has the Ram for you.
And you know what they say, you can't believe everything you see on the internet. And that's true right now.
And we're back here on Lake Area Sports. Down to the wire here in this second set. It's been a very competitive second set after Atkins took the first by a 25-13 tally. 25-12, excuse me. And that one gets through the kill for Compton. Lady Mustangs 1 point away from knotting this thing up at one apiece. And they give the point to Hoxie, and they do knot the series up at 1-1. 25-22, they hold on as Atkins was creeping a bit closer there. and trying to go up 2-0. But instead, it's going to be 1-1 now. And we'll be back while they talk it over. We got about a 3-minute break here. Let's send it to another commercial here and be back here from Searcy in just a bit.
At American Safeguard Insurance, you get an actual human being just down the street to get advice on the confusing world of insurance. There's no need to shop around every time your insurance company tries to raise rates. You can relax and let us do it for you. Having a choice is a big deal, and when insurance companies compete, you save money. One of the most important benefits is we actually monitor your premium for rate increases. If we notice a rate increase, we reshop your premium to ensure the best rate. And when the time comes to use your insurance, and we hope it doesn't, you have a friend to help guide you during one of the most stressful times of your life. All your needs under one roof, from vehicle to life insurance, and everything in between. We protect it all.
Hey folks, Sean Gorham here for Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs, the Lake Area's fastest growing GM dealership, where we make your car buying experience easy and enjoyable. Simply shop cowboyscbg.com, where you can pick out your vehicle, get an appraisal, pre-approval, and even purchase from your living room. Every new vehicle purchased comes with a complimentary 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and we deliver anywhere in the state. The service don't stop there. We also have a state-of-the-art service facility and collision repair center. So for all your automotive needs, come see us at Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs.
And we're back out of the break as Hoxie knots it up at one set win apiece between themselves and Atkins as they're victorious 25-22 in that second set. And according to Mr. Scott McDonald, that is the first set that Atkins has dropped to a 3A team since September 6th to Episcopal. Episcopal will take the floor in the next game against Hackett. Wow, so they went well over a month without surrendering a set win to a 3A team. Impressive. Impressive run here for the Lady Red Devils. But credit Hoxie. They're able to hang on and force at least a fourth set here. We went a full five sets to end the day yesterday as, again, Harding Academy were able to hold off Charleston, and it goes out of bounds. The serve from Cunningham. Hoxie scores first. And a kill. Isley putting her team on the board. There's no question she is going to be she's already an all-state selection, but she will be an all-state tournament selection as well. You just know it here for the Lady Red Devils. Good save there by Brewer. And just gets over the net and through for Gately. Atkins takes advantage. 2-1. Isley trying to go for the block there. She nearly does, but there to cover was Compton. And too much on that hit. I believe that was Gately on that one. It goes out of bounds. Tied back up once again. It will not be the only tie nor lead change we'll see throughout the course of this match as we had a hoist of them in the second frame, second set. Point to Atkins. They're going to say touch the net, I believe. Could be wrong. believe that was Compton. I believe the official held up a 1-5. 3-3 now. And a double hit. Charge to Hoxie. Gives Atkins control of a slim one-point lead. That lead is short-lived for Hoxie. Brady, the serve for, or excuse me, the lead was short-lived for Atkins as they now reclaim the lead after the serve from Brady falls short, hits the net, and falls to the floor. And another point. Back and forth, man. That second set, which was just a three-point, it was only a three-point victory. I mean, not only a three-point victory, but credit Hoxie, they're able to hold on there by three. If that set, it very well may be evident of how the rest of this match goes. They just continue to trade blows left and right like a heavyweight bout. Hoxie with a quick 2 points, make it 3 points. Nice kill there for Forster. And skying up and getting Atkins back on the board is Cunningham. Great match. This one is set out to be Atkins, again, the number one seed out of the Northwest. Hoxie, the number two seed out of the Northeast. Osley gets it over to the third hit for Atkins. Nice dig there for Gooden. And the Lady Red Devil try sails out of bounds. And a block, number 21, Prater. Hoxie finds themselves with a 3-point advantage in this third set. Now make it a 2-point lead. Atkins is back on the board. And not much Atkins could do there. Try to recover. The advantage on that series is given to Hoxie, or they do get the advantage there and score another point. Oh, right through the hands it goes of Forrester. Cunningham with a point. Hoxie gets it over on the third hit from Forrester. And a double hit. And a substitution as Brewer will check in for Keister in an 11-9 game here in the third set. That one just stays in bounds. I believe that point will be awarded to Gilham. Good back and forth here on this series. Oh, wow. Nice play there by Gately. Her shot just gets over the net, but it finds the opening. Lands on the floor. She gets it down for the point and the kill. Out of bounds. Gilham, her shot sails to the right side. Oh, Brewer able to keep it alive. Right time, right place. Is coming short of getting it over the net was Gately. It's been a good one here from Searcy so far. Each team with a set win to their credit. It seems like one team adds a couple points to their total. The other team strikes right back with a couple, two or three of their own. It's been a set of runs, no question. A lot of ties, a lot of lead changes. There's another point for Hoxie. And they tack on another. 15-12, our score. Too much force on the hit from Osley. She's had a good performance here thus far in this contest. That makes it 16-12. Another timeout will be taken. We'll be back here on the AAA Digital Network, compliments of Lake Area Sports, in just a few moments.
Davis is more than just.
And we're back out of the timeout taken by Atkins. They trail at 16-12 here in the third set of the state quarterfinal matchup with Hoxie. Another good series here. Back and forth they go, answering one another. Good placement. Wow. How about that? Great play by Prater, able to get it across. But it goes down for the kill. Cunningham. Cut into the deficit. It's now down to three. Peters with the serve. as they give it. They award the point to Atkins. Inching a bit closer. Another serve from Peters. And it gets down for a kill. Number 10, Forrester, comes through. Finds an opening, open spot there on the floor. It's down for the kill. And a point goes to Forrester on her hit from the front line. Front row, I should say. Front line, front row. I suppose they both would be fitting terms from where she was at there. And another point. 18-15 as Cunningham's attempt gets caught through the net. And, wow, able to keep it alive was Prater. And a kill! Gooden comes through. Atkins Atkins with another serve. And I believe that was Isley. Her attempt falls short. A rare miscue for Isley. She has been automatic so far this afternoon in this one. Wow, another good series. Just getting it over across was Compton. Wow, you love to see the hard work and competitiveness right here. Wow, unable to save it there. Trying to go for the dive was Forrester. And Atkins brings it back down to a two-point lead for Hoxie. They're coming down to the wire once again, just like we did in the second set, as Isley, her block attempt, no good. 20-17 now. Forrester, the serve. She's had a good game herself. Forrester sets it up for Gilham. And unable to save it and keep it alive was Peters. Lady Mustangs on top by four. Now Atkins needs four to tie. Now three to tie as Isley continues her great game with another kill. Brewer set to serve. It's on its way. Forrester. Gately. Gilham. Is Ferguson the libero for Atkins. Again, strikes. He strikes again, keeping it alive. And they're going to set it up. Oh, it's short. Comes up short for Prater. Twenty-one to 19. Action-packed third set here from Searcy. Oh, a block that gets down for the point, Isley. Wow. And that makes it a one-point game, another timeout taken. We'll be back here to bring you the rest of this exciting third set as Hoxie leads it by one. We'll be back here on the AAA Digital Network, compliments of Lake Area Sports.
Nobody has sold more Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram vehicles than the Landers family. If you're looking for a hassle-free, stress-free buying experience, then Cowboy Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram & Clint is your place to shop. We've got all the trucks you're looking for with brand new V8 Ram trucks starting at just $29,988. If there's a job to be done.
Both teams back out on the floor, out of the timeout. Brewer will have the serve. Once again, and here it goes. We're back underway out of the timeout. Brewer, and it gets through. Oh, but no, they're going to say the point is awarded to Hoxie. Wow. A huge point to go back up by two. They are 3 points away from their second consecutive set win. Stoppage in action. Something, they're checking out something on the floor near on Hoxie's side. Not sure what's going on. Ah. Well, here comes a towel, maybe. I believe they're going to resume play now. And they will. 22-20, Hoxie leads Atkins. The serve from Prater, and it goes out of bounds. 23-20. Goes out of bounds off Atkins. Another timeout taken here. We'll be right back from Searcy in a few moments.
Physical Therapy in Heber Springs is a proud supporter of the Lake Area Athletes. If you or your student athlete are looking to get back in shape or for therapy after an injury, give Ivy Physical Therapy a call at 501-362-8118 or visit ivyphysicaltherapy.com.
And welcome back. We resume play. 23-20, our score in the third set. Hoxie leads Atkins. Now it's 23-21. Atkins with a quick point out of the break. Oh, what a kill for Gilham. 24-21, Hoxie a point away from taking set three and leading it 2-1. This is for the set point, the serve from Brady. Gooden. Oh, third hit, getting it across. Hoxie, what a big play there. Oh, as it, Osley comes short, and the ball falls to the floor, and Hoxie takes a 2-1 lead in this match after winning set three, 25-21. They fell behind. They came up short in the first set, 25-12. They won the second set, 25-22, and they're 25-21 winners in this third set. So we'll have the fourth set coming up as Atkins trails 2-1 now. We'll be back here on the AAA Digital Network, compliments of Lake Area Sports. Be right back.
Hey folks, Sean Gorham here for Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs, the Lake Area's fastest growing GM dealership, where we make your car buying experience easy and enjoyable. Simply shop cowboyscbg.com, where you can pick out your vehicle, get an appraisal, pre-approval, and even purchase from your living room. Every new vehicle purchased comes with a complimentary 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, and we deliver anywhere in the state. The service don't stop there. We also have a state-of-the-art service facility and collision repair center. So for all your automotive needs, come see us at Cowboy Chevrolet Buick GMC in Heber Springs.
Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy has been serving the Greers Ferry Lake area since 1976. They are located on the back side of the Court Square in downtown Heber Springs. Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy offers private consultations, Medicare enrollment, and immunizations for pneumonia, flu, COVID, shingles, tetanus, and more. They also test and treat strep and flu. Their staff is committed to providing fast and friendly service. Stop by today to see why Ivy's Family Disco Pharmacy is Greers Ferry Lake's number one independent pharmacy.
Set four about to begin here as Hoxie leads Atkins 2-1 in this quarterfinal matchup of the Class 3A state volleyball tournament live here on the AAA Digital Sports Network from Harding Academy. Sorry about that. Had a commercial run. Able to stop it there. But we are back here from Searcy. Harding Academy playing host to this 3A state volleyball tournament is Hoxie. After trailing 1-0 here to Atkins, they've won the last two sets. And they need one set win to advance to the semifinal round tomorrow. As for Atkins, they're trying to keep their season alive and force a fifth set. Good save at the net for Atkins. As Atkins will strike first in this fourth set. I was able to find the All-State selection list for Class 3A here, as for Atkins, Caitlin Osley, Abby Grace Cunningham, and Tommy Peters were all selected to the All-State team. As for Hoxie, they had four selections, Ellery Gilliam, Kara Forrester, Chloe Prater, and Bailey Prater. Four selections for Hoxie, three for Atkins. So seven All-Staters taking the floor here in this one. Congrats to those ladies on that honor. Oh. Hoxie now leads 2-1. Quick 2 points. Hard hit there from Gillum. And another kill, courtesy of the Lady Red Devils. They must win this set to keep their season alive. For Hoxie, a win here would move them into the next round, which is set for tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock. Oh, and that one deflects off of Brewer, off her right hand over near the Atkins bench. Hoxie back on top. Fireworks, theatrics all throughout this one. Brady serve. And a block right at the net for number 23, Gillum. 4-2. Wow, after that first set, Hoxie has looked like a different machine out here, a totally different squad, as Atkins went on a tear in that opening set. As Osley's telling her teammates, let's go. We got to get it together here. Wait, they know they can do it. And there she is with a kill. After the words of encouragement to her teammates, just to get it, get on one page and to attempt to make this comeback here. Five to three, Hoxie leads. And a block coming through with a point. Keister, and it'll be her turn to serve now. Six to three. Keister getting it over for Hoxie. Oh, and it's deflected off the libero. Brady sails to the floor. Now Osley with a serve. And it'll go out of bounds up into the student section, deflected off the hands there of Osley. Good hit from Cunningham. Getting it over Forrester. Good save from Osley in that back row, the back line there. And across it goes from Gooden. And that one sails out of bounds. Forrester, a bit too much as Osley hands the volleyball off to Peters. Osley, there to recover it, Greer, over the net by Forrester. And it goes through. Nobody there to cover it for Atkins. They watch it hit the floor. And it costs them having nobody there to make a move on it, to make a play on it. 8-5 now our score. And it gets through for a point off the serve from Prater, Chloe Prater. And that makes it 9-5. Another timeout taken here. We'll be back in a minute here on the AAA Digital Network. Compliments of Lake Area Sports. Be right back.
FL Davis is more than just a hardware store, with six locations to serve you in Heber Springs, Greers Ferry, Sherwood, Pea Ridge, Fayetteville, and Centerton. They are your one-stop shop for hardware.
Back out of the timeout here in this fourth set. Hoxie, 9, Atkins, 5. Now 10-5 as the serve, another serve gets down for a point for the Lady Mustangs. That was Chloe Prater. That's back-to-back points for her off serves. And she'll ring this one in. Isley to Peters. And a hard hit from Cunningham out of bounds. 3 quick points for Hoxie. Doubles their lead from 3-6. However, miscue on serve. Atkins back on the board. Down by 5 now. This is the official here on the staircase closest to us. Brings Isley over. And this place just went dead silent. She had a conversation, or official had a conversation there with Isley. Not sure what about, but it got very quiet in here. As Gately trying to return it, it gets caught in the net. 12-6. And out of bounds. Too much from Cunningham. As Gilham, off her hand, it hits the floor. Atkins with a much-needed point there. And they get it to cut it to 6. Cunningham the serve. And out of bounds, another quick point for Atkins. They need every point they can get as they are behind. They were early leaders in this match, 1-0, but it's been all Hoxie since that first set as they clip on another. Again, sometimes you need that first set. You're on a new court. You're getting used to the environment. You need a first set to get accustomed the rest of the way, and that seemed to be the case for Hoxie is they have looked like an entirely different team since Atkins won that first set. Brewer, and it stays in bounds. Brewer with the point off the serve. 4-point deficit now for the Lady Red Devils. Trying to get that much closer. Oh, what a dig there for Brewer, who just served it moments ago. And the volley falls short as the Lady Mustangs are ready for the block. And they score the point, 15-10 now. Brewer. And another one goes out of bounds. Ferguson. This is a senior-laden Atkins Lady Red Devil squad. 8 seniors. 3 juniors. And 7 sophomores. So a mix there of experience as well as youth, as those 8 seniors and 7 sophomores, a lot of young girls, but also a lot of older girls for Atkins. It's 17-10, another quick 2, or excuse me, 17-11. Hoxie they're somewhat young themselves. Four seniors. Only one junior listed on the roster, and that's Prater, number 21. As for the sophomore department, nine sophomores and one freshman. Wow. Pretty young team here for Hoxie. More sophomores than seniors or juniors. Very young team. Two lady Red Devils in on the hit, getting it across. Osley keeps it alive for Gately. Brady. And the point to Forrester. Deflected off the Lady Red Devils, out of bounds near their bench. And the point to Atkins, a double hit. 19-13. Atkins needing a rally to get back in and attempt to force a fifth set. And they get another point there. It's Prater. Her hit is too much, has too much force on it. And it stays in bounds. Wow. Brady had a play on it. She watches it hit the ground. And 19-16, a great block there by Cunningham. And we're going to have another timeout taken as the deficit's cut down to three for Atkins. The momentum is in their direction at the moment. We'll be back here on the AAA Digital Network. Compliments of Lake Area Sports after this commercial break. Keep it locked right here.
What do you do with your Ram truck? Are you pulling a trailer? Pulling a boat to the lake to enjoy some time with your family? Or are you enjoying nature and taking your Ram off-road? Whatever you're doing with your Ram, Red River Dodge of Heber Springs has the Ram for you.
And you know what they say, you can't believe everything you see on the internet. And that's true right now. Not every new Ram truck that we have is showing up online. Go to our website at redriverdodge.com.
Well, that was a quick timeout, Blink, and it's said and done, pretty much. 19-16, Hoxie leads Atkins here in the fourth set. Hoxie looking to put this one away. As for Atkins, they're trying to work their way in and force a fifth set. And they get that much closer. Another point. The momentum continues to stay on the side of the Lady Red Devils on that out-of-bounds hit from Hoxie. And another point. Brady can't get it to go the way she intended. 19-18. Serving will be Peters for Atkins. Another exciting set here in this one. Gillum finds Prater. Forrester. To Osley, getting it across. And another point, Atkins. We're tied. 19-19 on the double hit from Hoxie. Wow. Atkins can go for the lead on this series. Here they go. And it goes through for a point. That ends the Lady Mustangs drought. Big run there from Atkins to get right back in it, but the 20th point is scored by the Lady Mustangs. Serving now will be Chloe Prater for Hoxie with a slim one-point advantage. And it's through the kill. Cunningham, we're tied again. Pandemonium here in just the first game from Searcy today. And out of bounds. The serve by Gooden goes out of bounds. 21-20. One team looking to advance. The other team looking to keep their season alive. And wow, block nearly got down, and Hoxie returns over the net. And it is down. That point gets down. 22-20, deflected off Atkins, out of bounds it went. Forrester will now serve, one of the four seniors on this Lady Mustang squad. Gets it across, sending it over to Peters for Atkins. That one hit up by Gately. Osley, Gilham. Gilham, try and go for the point, she'll get it! Number 23 comes through with the 23rd point in this fourth set. 2 points away now is Hoxie. But Atkins keeping it close, 23-21. Cunningham with a point of her own. Forrester, and wow, Atkins able to get it across on the third hit, sending it over to Gilham, deflected, second hit, now a third, Osley getting it over once again for the Lady Red Devils. Oh, that one's going to be, wow, can they get it over on the third hit? They can, but it goes out of bounds. Atkins running out of room. We're just able to get it across as we are now to the set and match point right here for Hoxie. Prater the serve. Gately. Oh, just able to keep it alive on the dig is Hoxie. And it's through. Osley, a point. Volleyball deflected off of Greer. 24-22 now. My goodness, what an exciting one here. Brewer the serve. Setting it up. And it's going to get down for the point. Hoxie advances to the semifinal round tomorrow with a 3-1 victory over Atkins. They play the upset card here in the opening game of quarterfinal action here from Searcy. Congratulations to the Lady Mustangs, the number 2 seed out of the Northeast. They take down Atkins, the number 1 seed out of the Northwest. What a game. What a match here. As Hoxie moves on. Hoxie moves on to the semifinal round tomorrow at 1 o'clock where they'll play the winner of the next contest between Hackett and Episcopal. Wow. And there it is. 3-1. Lady Mustangs are victorious. They fell behind 1-0 in the first set after Atkins won it 25-12. They doubled up on Hoxie, plus one more point. Atkins looked so dominant in that first set, but Hoxie got some wind in their sails in the second, third, and fourth set, and they were winners in the second set, 25-22. Third set, 25-21, and that fourth and final set, 25-22. They're able to hold on for three straight, and they move on. So, again, congrats to the Lady Mustangs of Hoxie. Congratulations to the Lady Red Devils on Atkins of Atkins on a great season. I believe Atkins will finish their season with a mark of 17-6, as that record shown on your screen there is before yesterday's action. For Hoxie, it looks like they'll roll to 21-2. Great record, 21 wins, 2 losses, heading into the Final Four tomorrow. Well, we're going to wrap up coverage on this game. Be sure to join us back at 2 o'clock as we'll have Hackett taking on Episcopal. Should be a good one. All right. Well, for Richard Sharp and for us at the AAA Digital Network, compliments of Lake Area Sports. We want to wish everyone a great rest of the day. Be safe out there. And if you can, join us back at 2 o'clock, and we'll bring you the next quarterfinal matchup between Hackett and Episcopal. Again, Hoxie victorious in 4 sets, 3-1 over Atkins. They lost 25-12, Atkins won the first one 25-12, then Hoxie bounced back with 3 straight set wins, 25-22, 25-21, and 25-22. So again, for all of us, we'll log off here and be back at 2 o'clock. In the meantime, have a great rest of the day. See you then.